There's a really fantastic video that you're about to watch, and it really, really explains our concepts about how important it is to give information to your dog in general, whether that's reward-based or correctional-based. And if you're only doing reward-based, your dog is missing out on 50% of the information that's out there. And once you've taught great foundation work, it makes a lot of sense why you would want to now start holding your dog accountable for mistakes it makes on known commands. And when it comes to a lot of nervous, fearful dogs, it actually is the best way to advocate for your dog. Because when your dog is nervous and fearful, it's not thinking right. So someone's got to think right. And if we think too emotionally, now we've got two things, one human, one dog, not thinking right. So someone's got to think right. Let it be you. Don't forget, guys, if you like our videos, if you like our channel, if you want to see more stuff like this, make sure you subscribe to our channel. Hit your notification button so you'll be the first to see a lot of our videos. Also remember, a lot of our stuff is put on our Patreon channel exclusively. Hey guys, how are you? It's Jeff of Sally Canine Training, and I want to do a great little module on working with nervous, fearful, anxious dogs who also can be reactive, even if it's selective reactivity, but also be non-compliant on known behaviors. So here's the thing. These two dogs are housemates, and they each came in with their own issues. In fact, if you remember, this dog lunged at my face when it first came in, and this dog was barking out of control. And actually, this dog is very, very nervous. You can see, look how nervous it is and concerned. It's like, it's nervous, it's concerned. It's like this even with the people that work with these dogs every day. So let's go through our training program. We start all the dogs. The first thing we did was we had to obviously stop this dog from biting my face day one. We had to stop this dog from barking out of control day one. Great, now we're done. Now we start working on obedience. Tons of food, tons of leash guidance, tons of positive reinforcement. But obviously, if any of the dangerous behaviors come up, we've got to stop. But there's no corrections for any of the obedience work. So what do? Teach them their core behaviors, sit, down, place, recall, go in your kennel, you know, how to walk properly on a leash. It's all done with a reward-based protocol. Then what you're doing is you're doing lots of reps, hundreds of reps. So inside, they're doing great. One-on-one, one dog. Outside, they're doing great, one-on-one. So we know they know the commands. Now, start adding in layers of environmentals / distractions. You start seeing them all of a sudden be selective with their hearing. My dog is stubborn, my dog is unmotivated, my dog doesn't pay attention to me. My dog has selective hearing. You know, these are what the catchphrases then people use. But the dog knows the command. So that's where your corrections for non-compliance of a known behavior come in. When you have done great foundational work, doing more great foundational work is not going to make it better. It'll make it better with no distractions, but it won't make it better with distractions. So what do? That's when you have to learn how to apply a correction and a punisher. By the way, correction, punishment are the same thing. We have different emotional connections to those words, but it's the same thing. It's just the opposite of a reward. It's unemotional, matter of fact, no, immediately followed by a consequence. What's that consequence? Ones that either motivate the dog to do something or motivate the dog to not do something. And it's very fair in obedience once the dog has a great baseline of obedience. So teaching them more obedience is not going to stop them from chasing squirrels, from picking up things off the ground. Now, that's why it's important to learn how to properly apply a correction / punisher for noncompliance of a known behavior. If not, you'll be working so tirelessly for so many months and possibly years, and you're not going to move forward. And this doesn't mean you're lazy. It's fair and it's effective. Now what happens is this. All of a sudden now, that goes well. outside with distractions, inside with distractions, out in public, another layer of distractions. But guess what? You have this knowledge now how to stop the nonsense. So what do? Outside with lots of distractions, the frequency of your corrections might be more frequent, but they're unemotional and they're fair. Obviously, the more the dog then becomes successful, the more they get it right, there's your reward, but you still gotta have in your back pocket a way to stop unwanted behaviors. Okay, these dogs now are doing great through every stage that I took. Here we go, they're housemates. Put them together on the walk. There's a very scientific term for them acting out of control when they're together. It's called shit show. Now, the shit show is, What the hell? Don't you guys know how to heal properly? They do, but together, it's like, what happened to all that training? What happened to all that great stuff? Okay, so by the way, I put that on the command. You guys missed it. It was a hand signal, okay? Remember, I'm the guy that you try to bite.
Yeah, rub my belly.
Okay, yeah, that's me. Yeah, really? You want kisses too? Yes, you're such a good dog. Okay, so anyway, now what we have is this. They already know how to heal by themselves. So teaching them how to heal by themselves more will not help teaching them how to heal together better. What do? You have to learn another scientific term, which is called cut the shit. And that scientific term means, hey, ladies and gentlemen, cut the shit. That's with applying your correction slash punisher. And then they go, oh, well, we didn't know. I know, I'm teaching you. So the correction comes first for the nonsense, and then, you can reward for walking together politely, but guess what? Sometimes in a scenario where that is in public on the walk, the lack of a correction is the reward. Now that's not in everything we do, but at some point, after hundreds and hundreds of reps, and literally over 100 miles of walking, it's time to cut the shit, guys. And that's where the cut the shit training comes in. So if you go to our website and it's alphabetical, under C is the cut the shit video. And I think it's important that people understand that when it comes to obedience, you are being fair. Why? Because you've put the groundwork in. Doing more of the same does not mean you get better results. It means you just get better the same. So when you introduce new stuff, what you've got to start doing is communicating to the dog what's acceptable and what's not acceptable. So how do you teach a dog to walk politely with each other? Step one, I've got to correct your unwanted behavior. Great. That alone teaches them. Okay, fine. So all these hundreds of miles of walking we've been doing by ourselves, you want it to look the same? Yes, exactly. And that's what we did. And this dog is very, very nervous and fearful. This dog can be reactive. This dog can be very, very reactive. No excuses. Walk politely. At the first sign of reactivity, you've got to correct that. So when we demonstrate all those, like each one of those little things in lots of different videos, but I wanted to give a different philosophy on working with dogs. So with your nervous, fearful, anxious, or reactive, you don't get a free pass. So this young lady is extremely nervous and fearful and reactive. But there's a level of expectation of behavior after we've explained the rules to you, after we've taught the rules to you, after we've role-played the rules, and after we've practiced the rules hundreds of times. And I think that's what owners are missing. They're missing that component of, it's time to stop the nonsense, because I've trained you, now it's time to perform. Now it's time to put it into practice in the real world. So a little bit of tidbit of information, just wanted to throw that out there for you because I know you've been following the journey of both of these dogs. Jeff Gelman, Sally Canine Training. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Make sure you hit your notification bell. If you like this, madly in love with you, excited to keep bringing you more content. Thanks so much for watching.